Dr. Mukong Adeso. I'm a general surgeon. I do general surgery cases like hernias and gallbladders, and I work mostly at Retreat Doctors Hospital, Henrico Doctors Hospital, and Param Doctors Hospital. I've always liked general surgery because I like how the patients feel better instantaneously. You come in with a problem, you fix it, and they feel good. For example, if you have a hernia, there's an obvious defect, you fix the hernia, you can see the change, and they go home. You come in with inflamed gallbladder or appendix, you're hurting, you do work, you take out the gallbladder, you take out the appendix, they feel better and go home. So I've always liked that aspect about it. It's also challenging sometimes, technically challenging, which is also, it keeps it interesting. I'm originally from Cameroon, I came here after high school. I went to medical school at Howard University. Then I did my residency in general surgery at MCV VCU. Then I did a one-year fellowship in minimal invasive surgery at UVA, University of Virginia. After that, I came to Richmond and I've been a practicing general surgeon since then. When you have a hernia, you basically have a defect in the abdominal wall. You got to think of your abdomen, I mean, we all see the skin, but you got to think of the abdominal wall as having different layers. And so if you have a weakness in one of the layers, what happens is you end up with a hole there or a defect. And so you see a bulge, but the problem is not the bulge. The problem is what's going through the defect. So the idea of a hernia or a hernia operation is to close that defect, be it in the groin or the belly. No matter which technique you use, at the end of the day, you're closing a defect. If you do it open approach, you're making a big incision to close the defect. But if you go with the robot, which is why the robot is great, you end up with small incisions to close the same defect. So you're making three or so small incisions. You're going in, you have wrist-like action. You can actually close the hole with stitches, and then you can lay your mesh for reinforcement. So you're still closing the hole, but this time you're making small incisions, so it's less pain and less chance of infection. At the end of the day, when you come in, it should be a discussion between the surgeon and the patient as to which option is good. But usually when it comes to gallbladders and hernias, robot surgery is usually the way to go. So you have robotic and you have laparoscopic. They both use small incisions. The difference though is with the robot, you kind of have like wrist-like action. With a laparoscope, you don't have that. So as a result, when you're using a robot, you can do a lot more. You see better because the visualization is good. And since you have the wrist-like action, you can actually do stitches and do a lot more dissection. With a laparoscope, on the other hand, you're kind of limited. So yes, you have small incisions, but you're very limited in what you can do. And the visualization is not as good. So you end up with a more precise surgery with a robot, and you can do more still with the small incisions. In robotic surgery, even though the word robotic is out there, it is really not a robot per se. In other words, the machine does nothing unless you control it. So the surgeon has 100% control of it. These are really just fine, small instruments that do a lot that you can control. So at the end of the day, you're putting in the instruments, but you're controlling every move, every twist, everything about it. So yes, it's called a robot, but really you're controlling 100% of it. The advantage again is just that you have way more mobility because the instruments are fine and they have a lot of movement. But yeah, you're controlling everything about it. If it just sits there, if you don't control it, it does nothing. The engineers are basically making it better. The instruments are finer, the visualization is getting better, the mobility of the instruments are getting better. So I think the sky is the limit when it comes to technology, robotics, and surgery.